Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we are going to test and make some Starlite. And what is Starlite, you ask? That's a good question. Actually, nobody knows. Starlite is like, it's really good heat insulator that can take really high temperatures. And some British guy like figured out how to make it. And then he showed off how good it is, and then he didn't tell how to make it, and then he died. And and that was all the story so far, but then like a couple of weeks ago, YouTube channel Nighthawk in Light. Is it that hard? Yeah, but nevertheless, it's good channel. I leave link on description. The guy on that channel figured out how to make at least pretty goddamn close to original Starlite. And the original Starlite clip shows, it's from TV show, and they cover egg with this, and then they blast the egg with gas torch for quite long time, and the egg doesn't cook inside. And I'm pretty sure that this can do the same thing. And this is really simple to make. You just need to mix cornstarch, baking soda, and glue, and that's it. And we are going to make some on the end of this video, but first I'm going to show how it works. So this is my only piece that I have made so far, and I have made many tests already. As you can see, it's like
black,
but I will use this side. And the how this works shortly, the cornstarch is made out of carbon, and carbon has the highest melting point, or it doesn't actually melt at all from all the elements. I think it was close to 5000 degrees Celsius. So it's really good on taking heat. And then the baking soda, this turns into carbon dioxide when you heat this. So it makes like carbon foam that insulates the heat. And the hard to say, YouTube channel has much better video about how this works and how you make it. So go check that. I leave link in description. And there is also a link to a YouTube video about history of the Starlite. This is more about testing with this and oxy-acetylene torch, how good this is. And this is pretty hot. And as you can see, it turns to black. It makes that carbon foam. And I can feel the heat radiating on my like other body parts, but the hand under the Starlite, or what hell is this, my cheap ass version, it doesn't feel warm at all. So this is like really good. And I have already used this piece of the Starlite like really many times, so it's really good. And when you stop the cooking, it's like warm but not hot at all. Yeah, so it can easily take this, but how about much hotter oxy-acetylene torch?
Yep, and because we don't have oxy-acetylene on our own workshop, and you are not allowed to use like welding stuff there. We are going to do this test here. So I have my original piece of Starlite. And then I have oxy-acetylene torch. And this is completely different thing than the normal propane torch. This is much hotter. You can't feel.
Oh my, stop this, man.
small sparks, the material that you blow away from the surface, It's like, it felt pretty hot when it landed on your hand, but I didn't get any burns. Yep. And this is also completely cool already. And this side, I didn't feel anything on this side. But don't try this at home. And even I think that it's pretty stupid to do that. So I have stunt hand. This is made from Play-Doh.
I made it.
Yeah, if Play-Doh, I think Play-Doh melts around maybe 50 degrees.
Yeah.
And if your hand is 50 degrees hot, you are in big trouble. So we put this here, and then we are going to melt not. And I have also my other camera, and I check that this is lined correctly because I have really dark filter here. Yeah, that's really good. So this is like without the filter, and then with filter is
just black.
So maybe we now can see what the surface is doing while I'm heating it up. And I take those. And Anni's going to watch only through the camera, so Anni's eyes don't get fucked up. And I think we can melt the nut without melting the hand. So if you are brave, you could do this in your own hand also. Yeah. I'm not so brave. Yeah, it's melting now.
Wow.
Look. It's molten steel. Molten steel on my hand. I think the airflow from that like somehow ruined the surface of the Starlight, or then we just add too much heat because
oi,
because now it started to feel warm, not hot but warm, maybe like maybe around 60 degrees, but it didn't come through by any means even when melting steel. And also I think there was a lot of pressure from the gas blowing to the nut, and the nut pushed the Starlight and it prevented it doing its thing. So pretty interesting.
But how about our stunt hand?
Yeah, stunt hand. It's completely cold and not melted at all.
Yeah.
So
even fingers are good.
Yeah. I would say that you could melt steel on your own hand also. But
don't step that.
But don't try anything like this ever at home. Even with the gas torch, regular gas torch, it's really stupid idea. Don't do that ever.
Yeah, so that was the oxyacetylene. And we actually did the oxyacetylene before all previous tests with that. With this. And the place where the nut was with the oxyacetylene. I think the oxyacetylene flame was, the gas was, it was like blowing so hard that it reared off the material, and this is now actually burning from that point it came through. So if I cook it a little bit more, and if I put the flame really close, so it's almost like blowing there, I think you can feel money from that side. Is it coming through?
Yes, it's coming.
Yeah, so this is like the actually insulating part. It's pretty weak. You can like scrape it off like this. So if you have like really hard flame, it's going to make hole. And I think that's part of the reason why you don't see this used in anywhere or the like real Starlite. It's probably, you can probably make this harder, but it's the like, if it works like this with the carbon foam is going to be always pretty soft, so it's not probably perfect. These were both very hot, this and oxyacetylene, but I want to test this against thermite.
Yeah.
And I think we have to make some pots out from this, so we can put the thermite in and then light it and see if it comes through. Yep, so first we have to make like couple liters of this shit.
Yeah.
And it's pretty easy. We have all the stuff here. So let's start. Yep. So the ratio of cornstarch and baking soda is 10 to 1 or 1 kilogram of this and 100 grams of baking soda. So I think I'm going to put one of these here.
Yeah.
And see how much we have, and then I put 10 times the cornstarch stuff. And then you have to put shitload of glue, and I use Eri Kepper, yleisliima, universal liima. Ready at all, we need like roughly twice the amount of glue. Yep, and my idea is to cover these aluminium foil things with that stuff that we just made. So then this would be inside and thermite is going to be here. And the aluminium foil for the thermite, this is like joke. It's not going to make any effect on the thermite. And it's probably better idea to have like rubber gloves for this. This is like really sticky shit. Actually, let's put this inside. It's not going to work like that. Anni, we need the cornstarch here. And if you put cornstarch here, then it doesn't stick to your own hands. So it makes everything a lot easier to have everything covered in cornstarch all the time. Yeah, let's make like many of these so we can, they're going to probably turn out with different thicknesses. So they're going to be some better than others. That's the first one. I try to make this one a little bit thinner. So then we would have some like different amounts of this stuff against thermite. Or maybe the reason why this isn't like, didn't end up in use anywhere is that it's like really hard to handle. Yep, it was surprisingly hard to make a bit larger amount of this stuff. The mixing up the cornstarch and glue is pretty hard. But if you start with a lot of cornstarch and then add glue quite slowly, you can keep it like relatively unmessy. I think it's best way to get gloves and go with your hands. If you try to use like spoon or something like that, it doesn't really want to mix. And the normal universal glue that is meant for like woodwork and stuff like that, it's not probably that toxic and it's like really easy to wash from your hands before it dries. But it's probably better idea to use gloves. Yeah, we are going to now wait a couple days these to harden. And then on the Sunday's video we will fill up these with thermite. Yeah, and it's really interesting to see what the thermite does, because most of the tests with this stuff are made with flames. And then there is like just gas, hot gas against this stuff, but with thermite it's going to be molten metal and it's also much hotter than your typical like gas torch, so really interesting to see. What is on your opinion? Is it going to Is it going to burn through?
No.
No. I would say that it's not going to burn through, but the outside like of these is going to be hot when the thermite is cooled down. It's just so much of heat there. But it's interesting to see how fast it's going to be and stuff like that. Yeah, but subscribe the channel to see the Sunday's video. And if you want to learn more about this material, go check the videos that I have linked in the description. And this is also something that you can try at your home. This pretty nice like science test. Just don't burn your hands.
Or house.
Yeah, I think the better test to do is to cover the egg with this and then show that it doesn't cook, than that your hands are not maybe cooking. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.
And for today's extra content, new snow dump season is here. There is already pretty much of snow. It's like, it has been one cool snow day, and I think they are going to soon start to bring it more there. And I'm going to plan put my old cell phone somewhere there as a time-lapse camera for the whole winter. It's going to be a great year.